Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays Dark Souls 2. I'm Stealwing 33, and today, ladies and gentlemen, we are back in the Shaded Ruins, and I have discovered that apparently, the guy who lets us make boss weapons is around here somewhere. I am not sure where, but I think he might be past the boss fight. But we're going to be on the lookout for him. But today we're going to try to get vengeance on Scorpion Bitch. That's the plan anyway. Whether or not that happens remains to be seen. But we'll get there at some point. I'm having a good time with Dark Souls 2, actually. I'm like remembering how much fun these games can be when you don't remember everything about them. Don't get me wrong, like, I remember a fair bit about Dark Souls 2, but... like, I'm only remembering it after it's happening. So, like, this boss fight. Like, I remembered this boss fight, but only after I, like, got in here. So, like, I didn't have any time to, like, fucking prepare or anything like that. Ugh. Drink. Alright, so now, bitch is starting to use magic and shit. Roll, roll. Roll, roll. Good. Alright, now close the gap. Stab her. Not hit her. I meant to stab her with the... Ow. Oh, ah, shit. Alright, this is gonna be hard. The problem I have here right now is that, I'm dumb, and I don't know how to fight this boss. At all. So, we're gonna have to figure this out, because, this needs to happen at some point. I had somebody mention that the Drangleic shield could be used. It's got 100% block. Yes, you are correct, but as you can see, while I'm holding it, because I don't have the stats, the block drops to 42 and the stability drops to 24. It's really bad. I don't want to use it. Well, I want to use it, but I don't want to use it right now. I got to get more strength. It's something that I keep meaning to do and keep forgetting to do, so, you know, I got that going for me, which is less than nice. I think Ornifex is, like, over there somewhere or something. I don't remember. Is that him? No, that's, like, another player who got frozen by the basilisks that are in there. Yeah, I don't remember. I don't remember where Ornifex is. He's in this area, apparently. I've got my map open, finally. Because I got kind of tired of walking around like a chicken with my head cut off. Granted, this map doesn't actually tell me, like, how to get to places. It just sort of tells me that things are in certain places. So, you know, that's shit. But, you know, oh, that's bad. Oh, right, let's get the fuck out of here. I ain't dealing with this. No way, no how. You couldn't pay me to deal with this. Well, I mean, you could. It wouldn't be very much either, actually. Be honest, I enjoy this a little bit too much to, like, demand payment for it. Let's chop down this hole. I don't know what's down here. This is the Pilgrim of the Dark. That's Ornifex, I think. So this is the Pilgrim of the Dark Covenant. I believe that this is the PvP Covenant. You gotta, like, do a bunch of shit to do it. And I think this is Ornifex.
Ah, look how far this undead has gone. And a very fit, a bit too alive. But with a darkish shadow. And like every undead, oh my, don't mind me, but if you find a need for a the dark is...
Alright, well, that's not Ornifex then, I guess. He's around here somewhere, according to this map at least. But this is the guy who's in charge of the Pilgrims of the Dark. He might actually be the guy I'm looking for, but basically there are people who, the guy who turns boss souls into... weapons is around here somewhere, and I want to see if there's any of them that are straight, like a stabbing weapon. Oh, that's bad. Gotta get out of the way here, please. Quickly, before they fart curse on me. I guess they burp curse, because it comes out of their mouths, or what I assume is their mouth. I've had that actually recently, that, apparently the big, those aren't eyes on top of their head, they're just like bulbous growths that are supposed to look like eyes in order to trick predators. Their actual eyes are, like, really tiny. You can kind of see them, like, right on top of their, like, mouths. You can kind of see, like, two little things right there. They're like right on the sides, like right over the right under the G and toggle. You can see like their little eyes down there. That's kind of interesting. It's a fun fact with Stealwing 33.
Did you know that basilisks are originally serpent-like creatures who were known for turning their victims to stone? Did you know?
There's something down there. Can I get down there somehow? Yeah, there's like marks down there. Like I can talk to somebody over there. Ooh, there's a path. There's a path over there. Ooh. Are we finding secrets? No. Okay. I think I know what happened. I think I need to get a fragrant branch of yore before I can get to Ornifex. I think that might be the case. I'm not gonna. You know what? We'll burn another. For the love of God. We'll burn another one of these. I don't know if using a different weapon would even be helping me right now. This boss is just kicking the shit out of me. Like, I'm not even getting hits in on her. The best one I did was, like, that first round where I just bum rushed her and stabbed the shit out of her. With, like, reckless abandon. Maybe that's the strat. Maybe the strat in Dark Souls is just to go ape shit and, you know, fuck the consequences. And fuck the king. Alright, let's get this on the way here. If we have to spend the entire episode fighting Scorpion Lady, I'm not gonna be surprised. I'm gonna be upset, but I'm not gonna be surprised. But we'll see how that goes. We shall see. I am not ready. No. But, let's see. Is there anyone I can summon for help around here? Anyone at all? Any NPCs? No? Alright. I know that the scorpion guy, you can get him to help you with this boss fight, but I don't know how to do that. There's, like, a thing you need to do to, like, be able to make that happen. Oh, shit. Dark Souls, why do you always do this? Sorry. Sometimes Dark Souls, like, closes randomly. I don't know how else to, like, really describe that other than it sometimes just, like, minimizes at random. It only happens, like, the first time I open it up, and then it doesn't happen again. And normally it happens, like, immediately, but it didn't happen this time. So I thought it just wasn't going to happen, because sometimes it doesn't happen, and then everything's fine. Drink. But yeah, I'm sorry about that. You probably noticed the fucking firefighter. The recording stopped, so, you know. Just, what up, bitch? What you got? Oh, you gotta do, like, an attack to knock this tree down. Not just stab at it with your spear. Like a fucking bitch. I find this highly uncomfortable. And I can see her. She's crawling around at the speed of sound. She's coming this way. Ugh! That would have been a good opportunity to attack her if I hadn't gotten pile-drived into the air. I guess you can't get pile-drived into the air. You get pile-drived into the ground. But, you know, work with me here. I'm actually not a big fan of wrestling. Then grow up with it. Well, that's not true. I like it now as an adult because I view it as like it's basically like a machismo soap opera is the best way to put it. All these fucking characters and, you know, people doing all this horse shit to one another and stuff. It's very interesting. Alright. We just gotta play it cool. If you can keep getting her to try to do that stabbing attack, it's really easy to dodge. So maybe for once in Dark Souls, hugging the boss isn't the right idea. My god, have we found a boss that breaks my pattern? Probably. I mean, it's probably not a good rule to have that every single enemy in the game can be beaten the same way. Somebody would have figured that out in bug testing. Because that's what bug testers do. We figure shit out. Now, I know that you have to get the boss to knock this tree down in order to, like... Ow. In order to get that item up there, which is some kind of ring, if I remember correctly, and she has to do like a tail stabbing attack. Oh no, she's got to sweep it with her tails. Got it. All right, well, bully to that then, I guess. Just gotta stay just far enough away to not like get destroyed by her tail attacks. And not get grabby-grabbied by the claws. Which, actually, you know what? It's going fine. It's a little concerned, but it seems to be fine now. Drink, please. Drink and then roll. Apparently cut off one of her tails. Not at all what I wanted to do, but, you know. Whatever, whatever. We're fine. I think we figured out the boss's Achilles heel here, and I think we're finally gonna be able to do this. Which, you know, it's fine. So I started watching Power Rangers Zeo last night. I do that sometimes. I'll pull up old shows and just, like, kind of watch them again. So I started watching Power Rangers Zeo. If you've never watched Power Rangers Zeo, it shows... It's camp. It's camp beyond camp. The bad guy in that is... his name is, King Mondo, the Machine King or some shit. And, it's just so funny. I'm remembering it, like, from when I was a kid, I remember being like, oh, those are bad guys. But, like, I was really young when those early seasons of Power Rangers were on, right? And so I don't remember too much about it. Where the fuck? I'm just going. I'm just running. I really hope I'm not leaving the Shaded Fortress, because I really want to... get Orn effects before I leave. Nope. I guess I left the fortress. I'm gonna have to figure out, like, look up where Orn effects is or something and, like, try to find him independently of the series and then start the episode there next time or something. I don't know. Elephant guard guys are so fucking slow. Get wrecked, nerd. I'll teach you to impersonate Krishnu. Now we got some dwarves. Dwarves? Never played dwarves. It's a good game, actually. It's like a tunnel simulator, I guess would be the best way to put it. You basically control a bunch of dwarves. You have to, like, dig tunnels to find treasure, to pay the dwarves, to buy ale, to make the dwarves drink, etc., etc. Oh, this is scary. It's our first mimic, guys. I'm glad that there were, like, an ass ton of, like, bloodstains around this thing, or I probably would have just opened it like an idiot. Black Scorpion Stinger and the Dark Leggings. Is the Black Scorpion Stinger a new straight weapon? Yes! Yes, it is! Ho-ho! Fantastic. Is it any good? It appears so. Ooh, and it's got, like a stabby-stabby moveset. See, now, this is what I thought a rapier was gonna be like, right? Lots of stabbing. Maybe we'll probably stick with this for a little while here, I guess. Go ahead and rest here for a minute. Get our charges back. Does this thing poison, too? Does that poison on it? It does have poison on it. So not only does it do a shit ton of damage, 200 against my plus 5 S-Doc, which does 157, but it also poisons people. It's got really shit scaling, from what I can tell. It's got no scaling. But that doesn't matter too much. Well, I guess that means the S-Doc probably does more damage, right? 124 versus 224 versus 220, but this has the poison attached to it, so, I mean, there you have it, folks. That's not bad. And if you can hit somebody enough with it, it poisons them, so, you know, enemies susceptible to poison will be poisoned. What you got, bitch? You ain't got shit? Oh, that's bad. He hit me with an anvil. What up, nerd? Old mundane stone. No idea what that does. Alright, let's, I came over here because I wanted to take a peek around here, because I believe that the other direction is, progression. But this is Orn effects, isn't it? Oi! Nope, that's not Orn effects, it's just a dwarf with an anvil. Ha-cha! Hit-coom! There you go. Guy's dead now. What up, nerd? Don't be a mimic. I started opening it, and my brain went, you should probably should have checked for their mimic to be there. I would have put a mimic there. Straight up, I'd have been like, put an enemy in front of it and then make it a mimic, and they will never fucking expect it. It'll be hilarious. Visions of a hole. Are you ready, therefore, wheel, huh? Are there wheel, bone wheel skeletons up here? I really hope not, because we're gonna have to, I'm gonna get fucking mad. Oh, shit. Well, piss. Guy trolled me. Trolled me to death. This scorpion stinger is pretty good. It probably upgrades with Twinkling Titanite. Which is likely why it does so much damage. There you go. You guys did a shit now. Hey, you ain't so funny now, are you, funny? Did you hear that? No, please don't fall off. Piss. I haven't gotten a single one of those yet. The rapier is not very good at, killing the fucking... those assholes. I think I hit the dudes on the ground in this game. That's fantastic. Large Titanite, sure, that's pretty good. We'll make good use of that in a little bit here. Bonfire? Gearim? I have no idea what that means. Gearim ahead. Oh, Gearim's the salesman guy who sells all the poison shit. Nope, that's bad. Anvil's attacking. Ow. Kill him. Alright, there we go. We good. We Gucci. We're still doing fine. I fucking forgot that we got this, like, dope-ass helmet. Oh, by the way, I changed our gender back. If you probably noticed, didn't notice, who cares. I went back to get vengeance on those hippo guys, and I was poking around just trying to see if there's anything over there that I missed, and while I was there, I decided to change the gender back. Not for any particular reason. Again, I didn't mind playing as a woman, I just... you know, I prefer to be a little more connected to my character. You know, it's not like it changes the stats or anything. Like, it has no discernible, practical reason for me to have changed it back, but I felt the need to, so I did. Radiant Life Gems, fantastic. Bombastic, Mr. Fantastic. Oh, I remember this place. This is like the battlefield, right? Yeah, there's like a bunch of horse shit around here. I have the vaguest idea of where I am right now. Apparently we could get to the Rat Authority boss fight from the Doors of Ferris. There's apparently a pair of, fucking Esta shards in here. I might have to go find those. Titanite chunk, useful. Large soul of a large proud knight. Nice, soul of an aimless soldier, a little less nice. And another one. Another one. Not bad, I remember this area. There's a pig monster around here somewhere that's horrible. Yeah, they're over there. I can see them. Yeah, those pig monsters are terrifying. Hey, there's a bonfire here. Oh, that's bad. Oi! Knock it off, eh? I'll mess you up. This thing needs to get upgraded. Peasant trousers. Fantastic. Right, let's go this way for a second, because it appears that this way is not progression. Ow. Ow. Please stop, Mr. Pig. There we go. Kill him. Kill him dead. Roll out of the way. Fantastic. Hup, 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 hup. There you go. Alright, fantastic. Kick the shit out of these pigs. Smooth and silky stone. Nice. We can trade those to the Snuggly Twins for items. Mostly rocks, which I think we turn into another lady in order to get upgrade material. In order to get there, we need to somehow get up there, which means going this way? Question mark? I have no idea where I'm going. Why the fuck would I want to come up here? What's the point of coming up here? Why is this here? Can I jump into that well? Would I even survive that fall? I don't think I would. I think that well goes down forever, right? No, there's a stoppage. Alright, I guess we'll drink and try to survive it. Alright. Two swigs of Estus should do the trick. And then we gotta go this way. Alright. Not a problem. I think that's the interesting thing about playing Dark Souls 2 is you guys get to hear a lot of my running commentary from, like, me trying to remember how to, like, what I should be doing, basically. Which, what's it called? Brain, fucking figure out the words you want to use before you start talking, like, because you don't look like a fucking idiot. I'm like a gungeon when, like I'm sort of just talking about what I'm doing. This is a lot more about, like, what am I supposed to be doing? Because, like, what I'm doing is coming up mechanically. Like, I just have played enough Dark Souls games to, like, kind of have a good idea. I can make that jump in there, but I'm, you know what? I'm sick of doing it. So, fucking get to it later. This poisonous stinger is going to break soon. Well, it's going to be at risk soon. There we go. We'll just, we'll kill this guy and then we'll stop using it. Stop that. Alright, cool. We'll just switch back. There we go. Alright, not a problem. Not a problem. Alright, we'll make this, try to make this jump one more time, and then we'll bail out of here. Because once, so Black Scorpion Stinger is almost broken, but that makes a good backup weapon. Oh, I made it! Hey, alright. Holy Water Urn. No idea what that does. It's not an item I'm familiar with. Ah, we end up back up in the house, though. Which means we can get this fucking chest right here. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Open it up. Human effigies times 5. It's actually really nice. Alright. Let's get the fuck out of here. I mean, let's progress, I guess, is the better term for that. Alright. We also need to go get, we need to get inside of the house, the mansion. I know how to get in there now. Well, somebody was an eager beaver. Ha ha ha. He died. I took a bunch of damage from the boulder, though. Alright. Enough to put me in red tearstone territory, too. Oh, I have these on my hotbar. What am I doing? Ooh, 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 ooh. What is this? What are you? Cleanse undead with holy essence. Alright. Yeah, I bet it just does, like, a ton of damage. Like, it's, like, one of those, like, throwable items. Like, I got knocked the fuck off of that mountain. That was funny. Watched it happen live, everybody. Ow. Oh, please don't fall off. Be cool for like 10 seconds more. Alright, easy does it. Just, ow. Ow! Oh, I'm alive! How am I alive? I shouldn't be alive. Shit. Well, I shouldn't have drank either. God damn it. Damn. We were doing so well, too. That's alright, the bonfire's like right behind us. I'm a little bummed out. Yeah, I know how to get into the mansion now. And I've been meaning to go back and do that, but I don't want to do it off camera, unless you guys want me to do it off camera. You guys aren't interested in seeing it. But I'll probably just start an episode, like, walking over there from Majula. Because I go back to Majula between episodes to, like, upgrade my gear and, you know, take care of, like, leveling up and stuff like that. But, you know, it's helpful. I do it off camera because I don't find that stuff to be very interesting to watch. And, you know, sometimes I go over it. Like, if you guys are interested in hearing about, like, how I'm building my character and stuff, then I, like, sometimes go into it. But generally, I try to do it off camera. Because I know from, like personally, I don't like watching people, like, go through menus and upgrade stuff. Unless they're playing, like, a strategy game. Like, that's different. I'm watching the game specifically to watch them go through menus and set up stuff. But, like, then there are, like, games like this, I'm more interested in watching them fight a boss than do anything else. But, you know, has its moments. Let's go ahead and kill that guy. Dodge that guy, then kill him. Fantastic! Fantastic! Drink up. Ba-doop. Alright, inside here is Spiderville, if I remember correctly. And if I remember correctly, this is my buddy Eric's. This is his favorite boss in the whole game. He loves this boss so much. He loves it more than he loves his own mother. It is his favorite boss fight in the whole fucking game. Where the fuck are they? Don't tell me they spawn in behind me. That would be unpleasant. Yeah, I fucking hate this area, by the way. I don't have, like, a fear of spiders or anything like that. But, these spiders are... they're very creepy. Don't be a trap. It was a trap. It was a trap the whole time. It spawned all the spiders. Oh, they're so creepy. Ooh. Oh, luckily they're bitch boys. Oh, they're really, like, it's just like, it's the chittering noise they make is, ugh. Gets in my ears. I don't like it. Like, I know, like, my brother's girlfriend, Chloe, does not like the sound of, like, hands on nylon. Like you know, like, if you ever worn, like, track pants, she hates it when you, like, rub that material. It, like, drives her fucking crazy. I can't stand, it's chittering, and then, like, it's, like, crunchy noises. Like, ugh, freaks the shit out of me. I really need to stop doing that. Like, on my hotbar. Like, I just need to hit down a couple times. And, you know, I guess it's because I only use them when I'm out of combat. Like, they're an out-of-combat heal, so, like... I'm a fucking liar. You're a goddamn liar. Alright. Alright, this is the spider boss fight, if I remember correctly. No, this is the big web. No, this is the Magus boss fight. Alright, fantastic, I guess. I guess we'll just stab the shit out of these guys for now, until I can get... I want to isolate the boss, that's the plan, anyway. Just try to avoid getting my ass kicked here. Ooh! I want to kill this asshole, and then we'll start in on the other asshole. Ow. Okay, drink, quickly. This boss fight's not hard. I remember some people have had trouble with it. But the only time you should really have trouble with this boss fight is if you have a weapon... if you are wholly unprepared for it, then you might have trouble here. I remember this boss fight being really easy, and especially after all the spiders. So that means the spider boss is indeed next. Ow, son of a bitch. That's right, then the fucking... you gotta kill the two guys with the bells first, because they heal everybody. Which, you know, kind of sucks a lot. Easy does it. Ah, there's just, it's too much, he's too close to the other boss. And then when that boss does that weird dark wave attack, I always get hit by it. Because I'm bad. Stab him one more time. There we go. Alright, cool. Both healers are dead, which means I can take my time and pick these guys apart really easy now. We'll get to the darkness guy in a second here. As soon as I have dealt with the rest of these assholes. Oh my god, that guy's... he's coming apart at the seams! He didn't know what to do. What's wrong, boy? It's like you've never been stabbed before. Probably hasn't, actually, now I'm thinking about it. It's not a common thing, getting stabbed. Yeah, alright, that was pretty easy. I'm, pleased with my performance here today. Ah, I can't hit him, he's on the ground. Like a piece of shit. Ah, it's like if I get too close to him, I can't hit him. There we go. Hey, that was easy. Stronger than before. Go, Zio! Yeah, that was pretty easy. And then if I remember correctly, the spider boss is next? I don't remember. There's a spider boss in the game, and it's absolutely Eric's favorite boss in the whole video game. Hurrah for rolling! Hurrah! Huzzah! There's a bonfire in there. heal up at the bonfire a little bit, and then we're gonna call it quits for this episode, I think. So thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you saw, let me know. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date on when I post more videos. And if you really like what you saw, leave a like. It helps the channel grow, helps me out a great deal, and of course, share it with your friends, you know? The more the merrier. Thank you all so much for watching, though. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!